So what are you going to do that's a little different than what you've been doing? You're going to look for more positive aspects where you stand. But that's kind of a trap sometimes, because when you've already identified a negative aspect and you look for positive aspects, the negative aspects just start looming bigger and bigger and bigger, and you can tell you're trying too hard. But you're going to look for more positive aspects. If we were standing in your physical shoes, first thing in the morning, we'd carve out a little bit of time, 15 or 20 minutes, to just quiet our mind, just to do our best to allow thoughts to subside, to focus on breathing or listen to the dripping faucet, or Esther likes to listen for the sound of the air conditioner in the room if there is one, just something. Her swimming pool makes a lot of noise, so she can focus on that, the sound of that water falling into the pool, just something that's steady and not too distracting. And as you focus on it, what happens is your active thoughts will become less and less and less and less active until there will be little or no active vibration going on within you. And as that happens, your vibration rises, and the physical sensation to you is sometimes it's a feeling of detachment. Sometimes you might feel a little movement. Sometimes you might translate it into an emotional state such as bliss or really feeling good. But what it really is, if it's really effective, is a feeling of detachment from what you are. If you're really there, you may not be able to identify the difference between how your foot feels and your nose feels. You just feel like consciousness and the identifying parts of your physical apparatus are unavailable to you or unimportant to you. And if you achieve that, let's say you meditate for 20 minutes, meaning you set that much time aside, and you only feel that way in the last minute or two, that is enough. You've accomplished enough feeling of detachment that your vibration has been allowed to rise by you. And now you are in a different state of receiving. And now everything in the environment that you were already planning to move into, you're already planning to see this person and go there and do these things, everything in those environments has shifted because you have moved into a different vehicle. Everything's going to look and feel and be different to you. Then impulses will occur to you, and you'll find yourself saying things that you don't usually say. You'll find yourself wanting to say, sometimes you'll even say it right out loud, don't know where that came from. I usually am not this bold. Don't know why I said that to you. Or you'll think of a story that doesn't really even seem that relative to what you're living, but it seems like something important, and the impulse to tell it is just undeniable. So you broadcast that story, you offer it into the mix, and then something comes from that that leads to something that leads to something. And there you are, fully witnessing with your eyes, your vibrational eyes wide open, the trail that you are following. And so this all sounds to most of you, we know, a little bit like, then I went over there, and 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 then I went over there. But we want it to sound like, I went over there and it felt really good, and I went over there and it felt really good, and I went over there and it felt really good, and I went over there and it felt really good. And I went over there and I met someone really nice, and I went over there and I had new insight into this, and I went over there and someone said something to me that they never said before, and I went over there and I said something to somebody that I'd never said before, and I went over there and then I remembered something that I hadn't remembered in a long time, and then I said it to the other person. I said, oh my God, I can't believe that you're saying this to me right now, because I was just thinking that same thing. And then you say, oh, we're getting the confirmation that we're on the same vibrational wavelength. And then you say, where have you been all my life? And they say, well, where are you in all my life? And then you kiss, and then you go off and you live happily ever after together. I mean, things like that happen all the time. Now, we sort of fast forwarded to the place that you're really most interested in, but what we want you to really feel from this is the way your life is unfolding. And so we want to leave you with these universal, non-physical, inner being mantras. This is what your inner beings want us to say to you right now. And they find you, for the most part, in a more receptive mode than usual. So this is what your inner being wants you to hear from them. And maybe it will be easier for you to hear it through Esther's vocabulary than through your own mind. But you'll be hearing from all of us personally, if it is your desire. You are in the exact place that you meant to be, and nothing is off schedule. Nothing is remotely wrong. Everything is right on track. And from this point forward, your conscious awareness of your motion is going to be a keener experience that you will each understand. There are a lot of people in this world that are here with you, and not any of them came to please you, but many of them will. Don't let them suck you in to forgetting what you heard today and remembering what you learned before that doesn't serve you. Don't look to other humans for your harmonic points. Oh, you're going to find a lot of them. But look to the source within you who will lead you to the humans. Because if you let source lead you, then when it comes, the two of you together will experience the power of the co-creation. You're already doing a lot of that, but you've been doing it unconsciously. You are on the brink of rapid unfolding. The money that you've been wanting is ready for you to receive. Don't freak out. Don't panic about it. Don't take score about it. Just notice it softly. Notice the subtle ways that the universe begins yielding to you so many of the things that you want. And nothing is off limits. You get to have it all. There is nothing that is off limits. Your lover is ready for you. Your money is ready for you. The environment is ready for you. There is nothing that has gone wrong. There is nothing in the world that you need to worry about. There is nothing that you need to push against. There's no place that you need to maneuver yourself to be in order to be at the right place at the right time. You have all of the understanding that you would ever want or need to have in order to consciously be the receiver of all of the things that you've been asking for. Your desires will never end. You're not ever going to feel satisfied. With each new thing that you allow into your experience, more will unfold. And people who don't understand, who begin to watch you, will wonder if you are not a little greedy as you begin to allow what will look to them like more than your fair share of abundance into your experience. Abundance of good friends and abundance of good times and abundance of the things that you've already identified that are wonderful about life. You must understand that it is supposed to be that way for you. You are meant to thrive. You came to be the creator of your own reality, and not one of you said, I'm going to create one I won't like. Not one of you said, I'm going to go create a reality and I'm going to hold myself in deprivation and sacrifice. Not one of you said that or meant that. You've just stumbled into that conclusion because you couldn't find your way out of the egotistical entanglement of the Cheesecake Factory menu that you think is what your life is all about. Are you sort of getting what we're getting at? And so as you leave the building and as you move out into your greater world, and as you begin playing with the people that you're accustomed to playing with, just radiate. You can't help it, but just radiate who you are. And don't spend any time in the next few days trying to explain to anybody anything that you're about. Because if you take the essence of what we've been talking about here and you try to explain it, these would be the accurate words that you would say to them, and it will not go over well with any of them. But these are the actual words that you would take away from this gathering. Dear one, I've decided to please myself a whole lot more than I have been. And while I love you, I'm going to leave the pleasing of you to you for a little while. I'm not going to stand on my head in any ways or jump through any hoops in order to get your approval or even your attention. I'm just going to give my undivided attention to me in the world, and I'm going to do my best to bask. And if anybody asks further, you might tell them some of the other things about focusing and isolating. I'm going to pay attention to how I feel, and that's going to be the reason that I spend time with anybody. I'm going to be with those who are really fun to be with. I'm going to be with those that I enjoy the conversation with. I'm going to let all of my choices be about how it feels to me. And I love you so much, but I'm going to look to you like the most selfish person that has ever walked this earth, because I'm going to be the most selfish person that has ever walked this earth, because I finally understand that in my selfishness, when I'm so selfish that I must be in connection with all that I am, then and only then will I have anything to give to anyone. And I'm not saying to you that I'm turning away from you. I'm saying to you that I'm going to tune into who I really am and really get good at that. And then I'm going to give you attention that you're really going to like. But in the meantime, go away and leave me alone. There is so much love for you now. And for now, we are complete. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.